Obstructions less than or equal to 18 inches below the sprinkler deflector. How do you position the sprinkler head to avoid being obstructed? You need to learn the 3 and 4 times rule. This is NFPA 13's representation of a typical spray sprinkler pattern. The discharge pattern for most sprinklers is fully developed at about a 4 foot distance below the sprinkler. Avoiding all obstructions in this space is not realistic. If you're in the business, you know there's always going to be pipes, conduit, ductwork, and structural steel that are underneath our sprinkler heads. This is why NFPA focuses on where most of the pattern development occurs. Continuous obstructions affecting 2 or more adjacent sprinklers and non-continuous obstructions affecting only a single sprinkler that are within 18 inches of the deflector are called obstructions to discharge pattern development. And this is where you will learn the 3 and 4 times rule. Here you can see all the different style heads listed in NFPA 13 that utilize the 3 and 4 times rule for obstructions that are less than or equal to 18 inches below the sprinkler deflector. The standard spray, upright, and pendant in the standard spray sidewall utilize the 3 times rule. The extended coverage, upright, pendant, sidewall, and the residential upright pendant sidewall will utilize the 4 times rule. So why is there a 3 and 4 times rule? It's because of the difference in spray pattern. The extended coverage and the residential fire sprinkler have a much wider and higher spray pattern. So the need for more space to develop that pattern is the reason why we will go from the 3 times with the standard spray to the 4 times with the extended coverage in the residential to give us more space to develop a spray pattern. Obstruction criteria for storage sprinklers in 811.5 for the CMSA control mode specific application and 812.5 for the ESFR, early suppression fast response, becomes more stringent because of the hazards they are covering and the different spray patterns they develop. The minimum distance of 18 inches is modified for the ESFR and CMSA sprinkler, which require a larger space for pattern development. The discharge pattern of the CMSA sprinkler is narrower than that of a standard spray upright and pendant. To allow the discharge pattern to develop and the sprinkler pattern to overlap, a 36 inch zone located below the sprinkler must be evaluated for potential obstructions to discharge pattern development. So for the CMSA head, we need to go from 18 inches like the style heads we just seen, to a 36 inch zone. The CMSA will use the 3 times rule for positioning the sprinkler to avoid being obstructed within that 36 inch zone. The ESFR, early suppression fast response sprinklers, are designed to suppress the fire, where all the other style heads we just went over, their goal is to control. Because of the ESFR's mission to suppress the fire, shadow areas caused by obstructions in the discharge pattern development zone of an ESFR could cause a fire in high-piled storage occupancy to grow so rapidly, the ESFR has its own set of rules and does not use the 3 or 4 times rule. All right, here they are, the figures for the 3 and 4 times rule. At the top, you can see the minimum distance from obstructions in the vertical orientation. For example, a column. At the bottom, you can see the minimum distance from obstructions in the horizontal position. NFPA is actually using open web truss as their example. Other examples of obstructions in the horizontal position could be piping, conduit, ductwork, and lighting. The 3 and 4 times rule is going to give us the distance we need to be from the obstruction when our head is within the discharge to pattern development zone. Now let's run through the figures. We are going to use the standard spray, upright, pendant, and sidewall so we can get a clear understanding of exactly how the formulas work using the 3 and 4 times rule. A, the distance from the sprinkler deflector to the obstruction. A needs to be greater than or equal to 3 times C or 3 times D, whichever dimension is greater. You need to use the 3 times rule only if A is less than or equal to 24 inches. 24 inches is called our clear distance. For the standard spray upright and pendant, if the obstruction is within our 18-inch zone, you have to be 24 inches away from the obstruction to the deflector. If you're over 24 inches, you don't have to use the 3 times rule. We're going to get a spray pattern that develops over the obstruction. Now, if we're within the 24 inches, that's when we'll use the 3 times rule. Here is an 8-inch pipe that's in our discharge to pattern development zone of 18 inches, and it is closer than 24 inches. So we're going to take 8 inches and we're going to multiply that by 3, and that's going to push us 24 inches away from the obstruction. Our spray pattern will develop over it. Okay, here is a 6-inch pipe that's within our 24-inch clear zone and within the 18-inch pattern to development zone. So we're going to take 6, multiply it by 3. It's going to push us 18 inches away from the obstruction. And now our pattern will develop over the obstruction. And that is how you use the figures for the horizontal obstructions. And we just used our standard spray heads for our example. 3 times rule in a 24-inch clear distance. When we are using the standard spray upright and pendant style heads in light and ordinary hazard occupancy only, structural members only shall be considered when applying the requirements of 865213, which is the discharge to pattern development section in the 3 times rule. And this basically is saying if the deflector is over an obstruction like ductwork, piping, conduit, or lighting, there's going to be enough spray over, as long as the obstruction isn't over 4 feet, that we are going to control the fire. This is only for standard spray uprights, pendants, and light and ordinary hazard occupancy. If the obstructions are so tight to the ceiling we cannot spray over, we always pivot to spraying under using the beam or the soffit rule. If we cannot achieve that, then we will treat the obstruction like a wall, drawing a line down the center of the obstruction. And always remember, if the obstruction is over 4 feet, we are going to need to use the wide obstruction rule and cover underneath the obstruction. Now we are going to use the 3 times rule, except in the vertical orientation. The head distances are the same as the horizontal. The standards have the 3 times rule. The extended coverage in the residential will use the 4 times rule. The big thing I want you to remember is they don't have the minimum clear distance like the horizontals do. Okay, we're just going to be using the 3 and 4 times rule. So let's check out this example. Distance A, side of obstruction to center of head, needs to be greater than or equal to 3 times C or D, whichever is greater. Okay, we're going to say D is 12 inches. Then we are going to multiply that by 3, the three times rule, and that will give us 36 inches. So A will need to be 36 inches away from the side of the obstruction. Now, the head will be positioned so the shadow area is not too big to lose control of the fire. The goal is to control. Whenever we have to move heads away from obstructions, always keep in mind the hazard occupancy we are in and the maximum distance the heads can be apart for the style heads you are using. If by using the 3 of the 4 times rule you avoid the obstruction, but you push the heads too far apart, we need to treat the obstruction like a wall. In that, we'll wrap up how to utilize the 3 and the 4 times rule. Always double check what you're doing by checking the style head section of the book for discharge pattern development. And good luck. I hope you learned something new. See you next time.